All right, welcome back, people. Today is day 5 of Inktober, October 5th. And today's prompt is map. So, again, I'm challenging myself to try to think a little bit out of the box, at least a lot out of the box if I could. So map can be an object which displays the relative distance between specific points of interest, right? It can also be a verb, like a cartographer maps things. Mapping can also mean finding the links between objects or points of interest. I went with something else. Well, it's still a map, but we're gonna try to practice something that has been pretty weak for myself lately. But first, okay, so the thing difficult about this is when I screw up, I'm going to screw up. So there's no rescuing it, per se. I guess the first thing we have to do is, this is a good opportunity for us to test which brush preset has the most dynamic lines, because the lines are going to be the most interesting. So that can't work. This can't work because I want something with different thickness too, not the shade. So the digital ones are out of the question, right? Let's see, so here's the digital one, right? This is all or none. This is pressure sensitive. Also pressure sensitive. But it's still the same thickness. So it's a very consistent thickness. This has a tail, sort of. Let's see. But now we're moving to brushes. Right. It's okay. Ooh. About pencil. No, the thickness doesn't change. So the brushes do so far. Nope. This one kind of does. This is the pencil. I think I kind of like this one. The soft pencil. Oh, we'll add this and remove the number 2. Number 2 isn't doing it for me. Okay. That's for future things. Dang it. Keep drawing on the background. Okay, where were we? This is the... Oops. This is the shader, so. This has direction. The same length. Now we're moving to the pens. Nope. These are like hardliners. Nope. Yeah, this is the one that I've been using. The G Pen. I'm a really big fan of the G Pen. It's still in the. Got this. It's too sketch. So, G Pen still wins. So we can. I was gonna use the G Pen today, but let's try this. Ooh. It's kind of like rough. Interesting. Ooh. Oh, that's interesting. Not what I'm looking for today, but I like that. The harder you press, the more, it's a calligraphy brush. I like it. Nope. These are markers. Nope. Thanks. Although, I could use that. Marker. I haven't done a marker thing yet. Oh, that's already there. Okay. What is this like? No thanks. Ooh, this is interesting too. For another purpose. Okay. Oh, I think we got our line tool of choice outside of this one that I used to use. I used last year a lot. I don't think it's gonna work for my purpose. Let's. All right. Looks like we're sticking to the G Pen. Okay. Alright, so this is going to be kind of hard. Let's make a gray background. And it's like a slightly darker side. Okay. I feel like I should just start the inside out. That'll give us more room to mess around with. Okay. This exercise is gonna be tough for me. No. Yeah. This is gonna be really tough for me. Okay. All right. It's basically like a no lift pen challenge. Try to keep true to this. Yeah, there's just no taking back after any of these, so that's probably gonna be the hardest part. There's a point to all of this. We'll see how well this works. Oh, these things have to be connected, so let's at least make sure they're connected. Son of a bee sting. Dang it. Okay. I wonder if that's how, back in the day, that's how they, did the mapping. 'Cause holy heck, this is hard. All right. As we continue the challenge. Clearly my glide and my Clearly my glide and my pressure is not even as I'm moving around. I'm not zoomed out far enough. Okay. Oh, it's actually not bad when you're resizing it. Okay. Okay. Trying our hardest. I can't do this too often or else I'm just basically never going to finish. This is supposed to be relaxing, so not doing anything too serious today. Amazing how unsteady Okay. Oops. My approach is starting to change as I'm going. Learning a few things about how I go about doing this. Hands getting steadier.
Thank you.
Okay. Wasn't so great. I can tell you that. Pretty good exercise. Just goes to show you how much, how much the eyes pay attention to line work, huh? Okay. What happens when you... and spend an hour on it. Okay. What happens if I... Nope. I think the easiest thing we can do is probably just provide contract. So oh, you know what? Oh, whoops. Actually, probably doing it on transparency is fine. Where was that marker? Was it this one? This one. Okay. I think we're definitely going with something else. Try the color one first. We could just do monochromatic, I suppose. Just do like man, this has been a very interesting experience for sure. Dang it. Thank you.
Hmm.
I think it's okay.
2 hours is.
Yeah, so in the future, body work. Can't do. The lines have to be very clean. Can't really do it with shit. My hand is shaky as heck going across the surface, though. Okay. I was seeing what happened if I drew continuous lines, but they're all enclosed. And none of the lines cross. It looks like we really do need lines to cross. I was trying to create an image without crossing any lines at all. That's tough to think about. I learned a few things. Well, keep that as a leave that up for as a learning experience. Oops. It was an alright experiment. It's nice to do. We tried to experiment. It was okay. Have the best. I'm off to the next experiment. For today, 2 hours on the short side. It was supposed to be relaxing, so it's just a lot of repetition. See how it feels. It's okay. Thought of a few things. Okay. That's a wrap. Day 5. Time to change gears.